So the trade discussion at this point probably won't change my economic forecast because, as I've said to you on other issues before, let's see what's actually implemented. It may be different than is being discussed right now. On the tax legislation, what I've also said is it has caused us to mark up our 2018 growth forecast and for 19 and 20 to a lesser extent. My concern is this. There are elements of this recent legislation that will actually improve sustainable growth in the United States. But the elements of the recent bill and also this budget agreement, I'm concerned will actually turn out to be a stimulus funded by increasing the debt, which will give us a bump in 18, less so in 19 and 20, and we're gonna return back down to trend growth, except we're gonna be more highly leveraged. I think that leverage at the government level and the future path of debt could become a headwind for you for economic growth in the United States. It certainly makes us a lot more interest rate sensitive, which is a vulnerability we're creating.
Are you surprised by what's happened with yields, or is it along with your lines of how you thought the 10-year or the longer-term rates might have reacted given what the Fed has done on the short end?
Well, part of the yield increase might be stronger economic growth. Part of the yield increase, my concern would be part of the yield increase may be the prospect of greater U.S. supply that has to get sold in the years ahead.
Right.
That would be a more ominous reason for the increase in yields. And so my concern is when you add aging demographics, slowing workforce growth, sluggish productivity, and now a third issue, which is the future path of government debt, I'm worried that that's a very bad combination for future growth in the U.S. economy.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.